I've used the one-minute paper, both as a statement of some kind of learning, and I've also used it as a way to offer me an understanding of something that I hope they've caught and learned, so that I can use it for evaluation purposes. That's not something I give feedback on, but I've had them write, well, I don't call it a one-minute paper, but I've had them write, say, a half a page. Oh, here's an example. Let's say that there's three major concepts that are underpinning a lecture, and the required reading material prior to the lecture has taken them into reading about that, those concepts. My agenda is to build on them, right? Not go over what the reading material did, but to build on them, to make that content come alive, to give it a life, lots of examples, to show the students how it's pertinent within their practice arena. So at the beginning of the class, I might ask the students to write a half a page about their understanding of the concept, but I don't want it written the way it is in the textbook. I want it written in a way that explains it to somebody who knows absolutely nothing about this content. Nothing. Which forces the students to drop away from the theoretical words into translating the theory into language that somebody else can understand. Sounds easy, hard to do.